Unemployment levels are being tipped to rise in the next few months. He's very good.
He's good.
I'll just sack someone for that. Something's happening with unemployment, which is not good news as we head into 2012. Of course, economists are warning a downturn in industry growth will see less jobs advertised.
The Australian Bureau of Statistics says 11 out of 19 industries are employing fewer people than they did a year ago. But it's not all doom and gloom. Some sectors are growing and hiring, but which ones?
Yeah, there's some good news out there. For more, we're joined by social researcher Mark McCrindle. Good morning to you, Mark. Nice to see you. Sorry you're in the middle of all this. What industries are feeling the pinch and not hiring?
Well, any sectors where jobs can be done cheaper overseas are really suffering. So manufacturing has been suffering for a fair while. But now with the slowdown in spending, and particularly the technology side of people buying online, retail, our massive retail sector, is under strain. You've got full-time jobs that are being moved to part-time, and some of the part-time jobs in retail are drying up.
Okay, so there, that's the bad news. Which one's booming?
Well, anything that follows the changes, the booms in population, will do well. So we've got an ageing population right now. Currently, we've got 3 million Australians aged over 65. By the middle of the century, we'll have 9 million in that age group. So anything that deals with older people, our retirement services, aged care is doing well. We've also got a baby boom taking place in Australia as well, more babies being born. So at the other end of the spectrum, you've got childcare really booming at the moment.
Any which way you look at it, you've got to be educated to tackle any business you want. So how's the teaching industry looking?
Teaching is doing well, again, because we've got more young people than ever. And you can't just put computers in front of kids. Any job that isn't going to be outmoded by technology will do well. Nursing, of course, you know, you can't offshore it, you can't outsource it, is also doing well.
We need to pay those guys more, though.
Yes.
We want to attract quality people. We need to pay them more. Mining industry remains strong?
It does. The two-speed economy continues to drive those mining jobs, provides good salaries as well, and it's a sustained boom. So a lot of investment going into WA and up north in Queensland, so good jobs there for the future.
Funny, isn't it, like 15 or 20 years ago, you would never have mentioned the words IT, you know, and now look at it, it is the big thing. Any new jobs, any new career paths likely to emerge in the new year?
There are whole new jobs that we couldn't even have imagined five years ago. Social media manager, cyber security personnel. You've got a retirement services agent meeting the needs of these retirees, as we said. You've got digital analysts just looking at the digital histories and helping in recruitment there. So technology is opening up a whole new field of jobs that we didn't see a few years ago.
Yeah, how do we future-proof our careers? Larry would like to know this.
Three quick tips on that. Firstly, it's about lifelong education. So remaining, keeping the skills.
Oh, you're out.
Shame. Yep. And what else?
Secondly, it's about people skills. Larry, you're doing well there.
Yeah, okay,
because computers can't replace us if we've got great people skills. And thirdly, it's about observing the trends and positioning ourselves so that we can respond to the changing demands rather than being sort of sidelined in an area that's going nowhere.
I understand the trends. Ruching and colour blocking.
Yeah, we're all over it. Two out of three ain't bad.
That's good. Mate, thank you very much.
Thanks, Larry.
Yeah, you'll be back next year.
No, I don't think I will.
Why?
Because I feel sorry for Adam, and I'm going, if he goes, because you've sacked him, then I'm going, and you'll be sitting here.
Boys, who said to Adam, you're sacked? Boys? It was Larry.
It all comes down to how much we bought them drinks at the pub last week. That's it. Anyway,
thank you.
Adam's gone. Mark, thank you very much, mate.
No worries.